What the frick is stopping you from doing what makes you happy, and how are we fixing it by the end of today? Money. Everything I enjoy costs money, and to make money, I need a job. Well, now I have money, but no time to do what I enjoy, because I have a job. Now I don't have time to enjoy it, unless I quit my job, but then again I won't have money. End me. I don't know what makes me happy tbh. Reddit is stopping me from going to sleep, so I'm going to be tired tomorrow, which will then make me unhappy. So I guess I'll get off Reddit and go to bed. I don't know what makes me happy. I'm in a gilded cage job compensation wise. I could afford to leave if I really wanted to, but I don't know where to go. You can't fix it for me today. Part of the solution has to be finding my own motivation and listening to my inner voice, rather than pleasing others or doing what's socially safe. Thank you for the daily prod, though. Found out yesterday my wife of 2 years has been cheating on me for 4 of the 6 years in our relationship. I'm going to see an attorney today. Life's a bitch. Procrastination. A baby who is only quiet and happy for me when I'm standing up. It's like he has an altimeter in his head that sets off an alarm whenever I try to sit down. Also, my dryer and dishwasher are broken, so I'm doing that cleaning manually, and the bathroom sink has a clog too far down the pipes for me to reach, and I can't seem to get my kids to listen or follow instructions without resorting to shouting at them. I don't like it, and they don't like it, but when I ask nicely or even command sternly, they barely acknowledge that I'm speaking. Because it can take years to undo damage done by toxic relationships and situations, I woke up one day and decided to go somewhere else and start a new life. I had all the hope in the world that my life would be the way I envisioned. Once I moved, I realized how much damage the few years prior had done to me. It's a long process and you always carry scars. I don't know what will make me happy. I'm lost and just going with the flow. I'm also very anxious about change, but open slightly to it. Still, I have absolutely no clue what to do or how to do it. Too much focus on happiness, not enough focus on gratitude. It doesn't make money until you're really good at it, and I need money and time to be good at it, but I use my time getting money. Money. Depression. I feel really stuck. I've been stuck for 10 years. I'm 28 now and feel lost. So I've decided to save as much as I can and move across the country in November to pursue my career. 1. Depression and anxiety. 2. Death. Money. Once you do something just so you have a roof over your head, they'll never let you do what you love to get the same results. Having a chronic illness with no cure. It's extremely unlikely to be fatal, but disqualifies me from basically anything I consider fun. Nothing. Nothing makes me happy. Money. All I want to do in life is stay in my bed 24/7 with my guy and kitties, playing video games and watching shows and movies. But that's not gonna pay the bills or get me out of debt. Because I've spent my entire life filling roles, first being a child, then a student, and now an employee, husband, and father. I never learned how to just be a person and now I'm lost. Money. Being an artist may make me happy, but it's fleeting when I remember I have no way to pay for the canvas, restock my paints, and no one will buy this crap because I can't paint something that looks like a photograph. As for fixing it by the end of today, fricked if I know. Welp, it feels like someone is trying to rip my left testicle out of my body and it hurts to walk. Today, I'm going to the doctor. Update 1. Hey, guys. It seems a few of you are actually concerned, and it's really sweet. I'm heading to the doctor in a couple hours, and will post another update as soon as I know something. Thanks. Update 2. Currently sitting in the doctor's office. I'm sweating bullets. Wish me luck. Update 3. So I just finished up with my appointment. She felt around my tidy bits, and it didn't make the pain worse or go away. I pointed to the spot where I felt like the pain was coming from, and she said that's where an inguinal hernia would come from. So she put her fingers there and made me cough, but felt no bulge. Her advice was ice it for a few days and keep taking ibuprofen. If it doesn't go away in a few days, I'll be making another appointment. Update 4, the 9th of January 18, it's been 4 days since I went to the doctor, and after the ibuprofen and resting, the pain is still prevalent and not seeming to go away. I'm trying to get back to the doctor either Monday or Tuesday so I can possibly get an ultrasound and or other screenings. I've been dealing with this pain for about a week now, and it's driving me absolutely insane. I'm a sad person, Chief. I overwork myself trying to impress everyone else and absolutely destroy myself, both emotionally and physically, in the process. I know I need antidepressants and someone to talk to, but I simply don't have the time due to working constantly. If I knew how to fix it, I would. I need a better job that pays more, and that's hard to come by where I currently am, and I want to move away. Totally out the country, in fact, and that in itself is scary. I'm attempting to quit smoking. Update, I'm going on my first 24 hours without a cigarette. Feeling great with only a couple cravings last night. It used to be my depression and anxiety, but I got medicated, and I encourage anyone who's struggling to seek help. But now it's money. This world revolves around money, and it feels like so many people are out to take mine. Yes, money doesn't buy happiness, but it sure solves a lot of problems. I assume it's doubt. I got a different job opportunity and spend a week with little to no sleep trying to figure out if taking it would be the good call. Would the new job get me further in life? Would it suck so hard I'd hate it? Will it be better than the one I have now? Where would I be in 10 years if I had taken it opposed to if I hadn't? Eventually I took the leap and start there early October. But still I'm not sure if it was the right call. I have this with every big decision and it's getting worse as I get older. Now I'm even starting to worry if my worrying will get in the way of my happiness. It's like a spiral. Being in shape makes me happy. Alcohol prevents that. 4 days without a drink as of today. Gonna try to keep it up for at least 60. I'm currently working in an office doing graphic design. And I feel bad because it does not make me happy. I hate office environments. I hate leaving my animals at home and my son in daycare for 9 hours a day. I'm bored by the work and feel trapped in the job. I can't tell if it's sunny or raining from my cubicle. The thing that would make me happy would be to work from home and create art to sell. But I know I would struggle to make enough money to make it worth it. I also don't create much art right now because I'm so tired by the end of the day between work and a kid and trying to maintain a clean-ish home. When I have some time to create, I feel super pressured to make something that I could possibly sell or turn into a print to sell. The pressure sometimes gets to me so bad that I just go to sleep instead. I'm so happy when I'm just working on a drawing or painting. It would be so amazing to be able to do that every day, but I might have to wait until I retire in, hopefully, 30 years. I'm one exam away from being a doctor, but having failed it once 2 years ago has spiraled me into a depression and procrastination cycle that lost me the love of my life and won't let me study for it again. I need just 1 month of solid studying with no mental pressure. Please lend me a brain. I wasn't really socialized in learning how to form relationships with other people, and now in my 30s I'm constantly lonely and depressed. I should see a therapist. But my employer believes seeing a therapist for anything other than marriage counseling is a sign that someone isn't happy to work there and they would find a reason to sack me. I've been trying for over a year to find a new job, but I can't even get an interview. I really wanted to phrase this as doing what you love over happy. I love you all and send the highest form of blessings to you all three. Work. I want to go to the gym 6 times a week like I used to. I want to see my girlfriend almost every day like I used to. She works 8 to 430, and I work on call. Some days I can't even text her if our breaks for work don't line up. We broke up because of it, and got back together after a week, when I promised I would be better about my time off with her. It's not really fixable unless I ask her to quit her well-paying job to go back to part-time shift work. To be frank, my kids. They are good kids and I love them dearly, but there is a lot of things I love doing and cannot do at the moment. About fixing it, well, I guess things will improve as they get older. Or maybe my definition of things that make me happy will just gradually adapt to my possibilities. that is actually already happening and very much depending on my current mood. I sometimes perceive that as giving up on my dreams, and sometimes as getting wiser slash finding happiness in little things. Basically, I need to work to pay bills. So if someone wants to pay me to be at home with my kids and my dog, I'm all for it. He really is the goodest boy. Money and time. My husband and I want to start a farm. We have the land. We have the tools. But we both work full-time at jobs that have nothing to do with farming. If one of us quits to do the farm thing, the other has to work harder to make up the lost income until our farm brings in revenue. I'm massively obese. 500 plus pounds. I'm in my 20s. Getting married in a month. And just recently adopted my fiance's son. His father killed himself before he was born. My own father spent his time in and out of prison my whole life growing up. I want to be the best father I can be. Take him fishing, camping, go to museums. Everything my own father didn't do with me, but my weight is stopping me. When I was younger, it wasn't such a big thing. But I've noticed in particular these last few years it's gotten worse. The month before I proposed to my fiancé, I went to a weight loss clinic to look into bariatric surgery. The doctors said my insurance covered it, so I signed up. I started eating right, working out. I lost a lot of weight. I did this for a year to meet the requirements for them to cover the cost. I jumped through every hoop they wanted. Go to submit it to insurance finally, and denied. They submit again, denied again. Come to find out my insurance will only cover insurance at specific weight loss centers they've pre-chosen and none are in my state. So I had to stop going. My fiance is an insanely supportive woman, and suggests we drive out of state every month for the appointments at one of these approved centers. But with work and a kid, that's gonna be really rough. Especially now that school has started. So, I don't know what I'm going to do. I spent a ton of money on appointments, heart scans, mental health appointments, nutritionists, all of that. I jumped through every hoop only to hit a brick wall. I want to be the best dad and husband I can be, but I know my weight is going to hold me back. This is a big reason I despise thin privilege or fat is beautiful mints that we live in nowadays. It is absolutely devastating to not only you, but those who care about you. I'm gonna see my mom for the first time in 10 years at my wedding. It is killing me inside that she's going to see me at my worst. I'm working on losing weight on my own through diet and light exercise. But as anybody can attest who's weighed this much, it is brutal, though I'm absolutely resolved to do so. Thanks for reading this if you did. I know I'm in a hole I dug myself, but telling internet strangers my woes honestly made me feel a bit better. IDK, what makes me happy in clinical depression? 1. I'm fat, ugly and gross and no one wants me around. 2. A successful GoFundMe for plastic surgery? r/wow thanks I'm cured. Money and I don't know what makes me happy. My job isn't too bad. I don't like it, but I can deal with it. I don't have the skills or education to get a job that pays better, so money is always a concern. In the last few months I started doing something I like, and I can do it at work, but half the time it feels like a job that doesn't pay. I'm just kind of passing through life right now, not doing anything. Also, thanks Opus. People like you who respond to most of the comments with positivity are nice. We need more optimism. I'm really depressed and hate myself. A lack of confidence. Not really fixing it by the end of the day, but being proactive nonetheless. I had a phone interview yesterday and freaking killed it. Got a call back for a face-to-face within hours. Got myself some clothes last night that fit properly, are age appropriate, and dress me for the job I really want. Not even the position I'm applying for. Today I'm getting my hair trimmed and some socks. I'm stoked for tomorrow. Lack of money. Fear to fail. Anxiety. Depression. Getting my house sold, so I can finish this long distance move, and be together with my wife and minion again. Edit. Well, at least this isn't my top voted comment ever, calling my son a minion. Overly aggressive questions make me feel insecure, and overbearing people who think they can fix my problems by themselves make me angry at people in general. I think we can fix the problem by leaving this thread and not being so assuming. Jabroni. /r/wow thanks I'm cured. Anxiety mostly, but I'm working on it. Broke up with woman I thought I'd marry. Feels bad, man. What the frick is stopping you from doing what makes you happy? War? How are we fixing it by the end of today? Love your optimism. Stay cute, Opus. Getting my cop blocking kids to chill the frick out while I bang my wife would be pretty super. 6-month-old has like some sort of sixth sense to scream when my peen goes near his mother. Don't know if Reddit can help with this one though. My mum has asked me to help her with getting her life sorted next week, and I was going to end it all tomorrow. So yay, I've got that going for me. There's this chemical imbalance in my brain that makes me think all of my friends hate me and that I hate myself. I'm marrying the love of my life. I have my dream job. But still, I sometimes feel so hopeless about myself that I can't enjoy any of it. It's got me believing my friends are only pretending and just put up with me because it's more convenient, and that my husband will realize one day I'm not worth the trouble. I know these things aren't true, but I can't make my head believe it. I want to be a writer. I want it more than anything else in the world, but I'm terrified of my work being rejected. So I never send it to publishers, or even let others read it. It makes other people uncomfortable. I'm not sure how to fix that. I'm gonna say a typical answer of time and money. I want to play games and go out with friends all the time and live carefree forever. But that's not the lifestyle that society needs from its people first and foremost. We need to work in order to sustain ourselves, the people around us, and the community we live in. My disability, my depression, and my anxiety. Shut up. Heroin is stopping me from being happy, and I'm proud to say I'm 18 days clean. Having a clear head is so much better than being in a constant fog. I get bored, but at least I have my self-respect back. I'm anxious about everything, so I overthink and jump to conclusions, always believing that the worst will happen. I'm seeing the girl I like for the first time since she said she liked me back through text, and I'm terrified of messing it up or ruining everything. It sucks that my brain decides to toss all this evidence and rationality that everything's going to be okay. But hopefully I can improve my confidence in myself. I'm going to try and get over my self-doubt and try my best FAP-OOV, though. It can't be fixed. I wake up every day sick to my stomach that I've been working since the age of 14. And I still have 20 plus more years of useless toil before I might have the opportunity to retire and actually enjoy life the way it was meant to be lived. Not yoke to a stupid freaking job that consumes the best years of our lives until we are enfeebled mentally or physically, or dead. We're all slaves. And if you think that sounds silly or hyperbolic, think about quitting your job tomorrow and going to live a life instead of real freedom and subsistence. And then realize it's just not possible. The inability to continue due to constraints, such as money, energy, and time. Tried following night school, online courses, googling tutorials, etc. just doesn't work out as I'm hoping it would. How dreadful it is to support 8 locations, about 500 workmates on site and or remotely, phones, network architecture, backup, development, maintenance, and so forth, with a department consisting of only 3 of us, underpaid, supporting 2 kids and a wife, about 10 euros left after bills, not growing at all in my job. Only thing left to make more money with what I have is working in the weekend, pretty much having to deprive my kids and wife even more. Additionally, there's no family from my side to rely on, since they are either dead, crazy, or abroad. So, in an act of desperate, I threw in my 10 euros into a lottery game this evening. Good freaking luck to me. I graduated college and had to move away from my girlfriend of 6 years because of the only decent job offer I received after months of unemployment. I make good money, bought a home at 23, and can afford most anything reasonable I want. But all I want is to be with her. We see each other on weekends and breaks, but I'm not happy unless I'm with her. Work hours. Too late. Today is over.